In this module, we're going to talk about oxides and how an oxide can be acidic or basic, or can form an acidic or basic solution. And we're also going to talk about the Lewis definition of acids and bases, our third definition for acids and bases. So oxides, depending upon what kind of oxide it is, it can form an acidic or a basic solution. The oxides that form acidic solutions are what we call covalent oxides. What's that? Well, oxide, it means oxygen, and covalent means that it's a covalently bonded to some other element, which means that that other element is a non-metal, sulfur, carbon, nitrogen, something like that. So these are some examples of covalent oxides and how they form acidic solutions. They do that by forming acids. Sulfur dioxide, for example, reacts with water and makes sulfurous acid. Sulfur trioxide makes sulfuric, and so on. We get nitric and nitrous acid from nitrogen dioxide in water. Some of these reactions here are pretty important in atmospheric chemistry. For example, combustion engines produce sulfur oxides and nitrogen oxides. When these oxides get up into the atmosphere, they react with the water that's up there and make acids, which contribute to acid rain. Now, alkaline metal oxides and alkaline earth metal oxides make basic solutions, except beryllium oxide. Beryllium oxide is an alkaline earth oxide, but it's amphoteric, meaning it can be either acidic or basic. That's because the beryllium ion can act as an acid, right? So it depends upon the environment as to what it acts, acidic or basic. But here, this is an example of an alkaline metal oxide being basic. Sodium oxide reacting with water to make sodium hydroxide. Here's an alkaline earth metal oxide. Calcium oxide reacting with water to make calcium hydroxide. These are both, strong bases. So the solution becomes basic from them. All right, the Lewis definition of an acid and a base. The way I remember the Lewis definition is I remember that it's everything's exactly the opposite of the Bronsted-Lowry definition. So the Bronsted-Lowry definition of an acid is a proton donor. To me, the opposite of a proton is basically a pair of electrons, and the opposite of donate is accept. So if a Bronsted-Lowry acid is a proton donor, a Lewis acid is an electron pair acceptor, and a Lewis base is an electron pair donor. This is an example of how that happens. When you react ammonia with boron trifluoride, the boron accepts a pair of electrons from nitrogen. Nitrogen's donating the electron pair, so it's a Lewis base, ammonia is. The boron trifluoride is accepting a pair of electrons. It's being a Lewis acid to make this compound over here. Now, whenever you have a Lewis acid-base reaction, you form what's called a coordinate covalent bond. All that is, it's a covalent bond where both of the electrons in the bond came from one atom as opposed to one from each atom on either side of the bond.